Now the much-anticipated arrest of Scott Sawyer. The feds busted the former ag leader as he stepped off a plane at JFK in New York today. Agents moved in today, they say, because they were concerned he was fleeing the country at some point with millions in hidden money. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen has more of the story. She's live in Salinas.
That's right, Dan. Scott Sawyer was arrested today in New York City. After getting off a flight from London, he was coming back into the country. He had been gone since October of last year.
Charged with 20 counts of mail and wire fraud, Scott Sawyer now in federal custody, connected with what's being called a scheme to defraud SK Foods' corporate customers, including Kraft Foods, Frito-Lay, and Safeway, to make sure those customers bought from SK Foods and bought at above market prices. Prosecutors say Sawyer also okayed the sale of tomato products with mold levels higher than levels approved by the USDA. Last year, facing bankruptcy and the closure of his companies, Sawyer sat down with Action News. We asked him if he could see a light at the end of the tunnel.
Absolutely, because good people will prevail. And we will have businesses going forward in the future. We're going to, you know, we're loyal to ourselves, loyal to the banks, loyal to our suppliers and growers.
Sawyer's lawyer blamed the failure of SK Foods and Sawyer American on former SK Foods broker, Randy Rahal.
Really boils down to one admitted felon making life miserable for a lot of people.
The key person providing information to the feds is Sawyer's former personal assistant, a woman named Jeannie Johnson, referred to in the complaint as JJ. She told prosecutors Sawyer was trying to obtain citizenship in a country that would not extradite him. She helped Sawyer set up residency in Paris, France, was asked to sell many of Sawyer's personal belongings, and helped transfer millions of Sawyer's dollars to banks in foreign countries.
Now, federal authorities have been tracking Sawyer's alleged efforts to move and hide millions of dollars. And, of course, that's why they acted now. Now, Johnson, that JJ that's referred to in the complaint, has not been charged or indicted at this point. But four high-ranking corporate purchasing managers pleaded guilty to receiving bribes from SK Foods between January of 2008 and January of 2009. And so has former SK Foods broker that you saw in that piece, Randy Rahal. Now, Sawyer will make his first court appearance in a New York City federal courtroom tomorrow. Dan.
All right. Thank you, Brittany. Now, the complaint also says that more charges and more searches may come in the near future. The maximum penalty just on the mail and wire fraud charges is 20 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.